Modelling can be a high-pressure business. It's so tough that one of our supermodel hopefuls has made the shock decision to quit the competition. In a moment, you'll find out who. Will it be your favourite model?
It just hurts me.
I just need a break.
They can see that I've been working really hard.
Lucas and Sheridan. Emotions have been running very high in the model mansion this week. That's because one of you has decided to leave the competition and give up the chance to become a supermodel. Can that person please reveal themselves? Lucas, because you wanted to leave, there was no need for Australia to cast their votes this week. That means Sarah and Sheridan, you are safe by default. You should now say your goodbyes to Lucas and leave the catwalk.
No regrets. No regrets. I'm going.
I stay, you guys go.
Okay. Come on.
You guys go.
Thanks, guys.
Come on.
God,
what just happened?
I'm in shock.
I just can't believe that he's actually gone. I'm just really numb, like
I'm shocked because I thought one of us would be going.
He was the only person in the house who was just like brutally honest. And he just told it how it was.
I'm gonna miss him.
Lucas, why have you decided to leave the competition?
I felt that there were things that took place that necessarily shouldn't have taken place, and it compromised something that was a part of me. And it upset me quite a bit.
If Sarah is put in the bottom three tomorrow because of her drawing out of this, challenge today, I will walk off this set.
During the competition, I felt at times really kind of isolated and outcast, ostracized at times.
I will talk about whatever I want, when I want, and I'm sick of you butting in and making comments about what I think and feel. No, don't whatever. I don't want to have tension with either of you. I don't want to be upset.
No, there's not going to be any tension.
Good.
Because there's no longer a relationship.
I'm sitting in the dressing room and I'm hearing Hannah bitch about me. And then as I come back, she's like, you look amazing.
Thank you.
I came into the show wanting to learn more about how to become a supermodel. And it's been fun. I've got to do a lot of things that I necessarily would never have been able to do. But in all honesty, I feel like my priorities have shifted and I decided that I want to get into acting. It's what I'm really, really passionate about.
But couldn't you do that when the show had finished and you did make a commitment to us?
Yeah, I did make a commitment, but I've always stood true to myself and I think that I've always been true to who I am, and I think that if I continued to, you know, stay in a reality TV show, it wouldn't be fair for me.
Lucas, I'm so disappointed. I'm hearing a lot about me, 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 me. What about the people? When you considered and came to this competition, you're standing in a spot. There's someone watching TV right now who could have had that spot.
I fought hard as everyone else did to get in this competition. There's no doubt about that. The only problem was that halfway through, I realised it wasn't for me.
Apart from all the rhetoric, though, aren't you essentially just being a quitter?
No, not at all. This is not quitting. This is letting go.
You've talked about modelling, you've talked about acting. Well, in that industry, you're going to be asked to do many things and you're going to be faced with a lot of challenges. I'm not sure that this business or the acting business is quite right for you. I don't think you quite understand it.
No, I fully understand it. During this, the transition of this show, I really got to learn more about me and where I what I really want and who I am. So I'm grateful and I wish all the other contestants all the best. I hope that they go off and you know, one of them will become a supermodel. And what more can I say?
What do you say to all your fans out there who voted for you?
To everyone out there that voted for me, everyone out there that supported me, thank you very much. I really appreciate it.
It's a bit of a shock, but we wish you luck. And you can now leave the catwalk.
Back at the house, the models had no idea that Lucas had left the competition.
Who has the least model potential out of the group?
Out of them three.
I reckon Lucas.
Oh, no. I reckon Lucas has got the most model potential out of them.
For sure, so do I.
Normally when the non-eliminated people come back into the house, it's one at a time they walk through the door.
And then they both walk through the door once, which is a massive shock.
So we're
Australia
there.
Didn't... No. Shh. We're standing there, okay? All Lucas right. is in the middle. All right. Don't give it away too fast. Jen goes, a model has decided to leave this week. Please step forward. He steps forward and she goes, there was no Australian vote. So he just leaves and we got off.
And we got off.
Sheridan and Sarah got a free ticket back into the house because Lucas offered to go home, and it's kind of unfair on the people that have gone up for the vote and have had to go through that voting station not knowing what's going to happen, so I think they got off very lightly.
He's been anxious and uptight ever since the first day I met him, and if he knew this wasn't right for him, he should have made the decision earlier.
Hi guys, well this week's been a very emotional and eventful week for everyone here, but it's time we get focused and back on track. Are you okay with that?
Yeah.
Okay, good. This week you'll be learning all about moving your body at different speeds and in different directions. As AFL fever builds ahead of Saturday's grand final, what better way to understand the movement of the body than a training session right here at ANZ Stadium with two of the game's best. So from Collingwood, please welcome Brodie Holland. This one's Ryan O'Keefe. Hey guys. How are you?
How are you going,
Dom? I'm Brody's from Collingwood and I'm a great supporter of Collingwood, so I was really excited.
Hi guys. In an intense AFL training session, we need to be able to move our bodies in a number of different ways.
Whether it's jumping, marking, running, it's important to know how your body works.
So it's very, very important to pay attention, because what you use today, you'll be using tomorrow in your photo shoot.
So these guys will be training you in two groups. So the captains will be Rhys and Luke, so pick your teams.
Me and Reese were appointed the two captains, so that was always good. I've always got a bit of a rivalry going on with him.
On my team, I picked Janina, Courtney, Sheridan and Tom, and Lukey picked Billy, Isaac, Hannah and Sarah.
Today I got the models to do a little bit of general fitness as a bit of a warm-up, and then we sort of worked on all the skills, handballing, marking, kicking.
Oh, great work, Sheridan.
I think I did really well today. I've got the athletic build and I can do well in sports, but then I guess with modelling I struggle a bit because I am a bit bigger than the other girls.
Lucas being gone has made a huge difference to the dynamic of the group. We all definitely needed this today just to get over the emotional struggles that everyone's been having during the week.
Come on, Reese.
Usually we have to do tasks and things, but this couldn't ask for anything more fun.
I think football can be a graceful sport, you know, just like modelling is very graceful.
How bad do you want to win this competition, Courtney? That bad.
The standouts, I'd say, would be Reese. He was cool, calm and collected, and he had a lot of skill. And Shanina was basically good at everything. Maybe that's because she's a Collingwood supporter, I'm not sure.
Yeah, we always have pretty rough training sessions, so it was good to come back and just chill at the model mansion.
You can just put it in the dishwasher. All you gotta do is rinse it and put it in the dishwasher.
I know. Now you know why I get so angry about the cleaning. Because it's a vicious cycle.
The house is messy. Most messiest in the morning, mid-morning, lunch, afternoon, just before dinner and after dinner. So pretty much, you know, all day, every day. We were all sitting down for dinner and we had a surprise visit from Martin Walsh.
Everybody down here right now, please!
You could sort of sense that something was wrong.
I'm a bit worried. If I'm going to put the resources and reputation of my agency, Chadwick, which has been in business for 30 years, behind one of you, I need absolute commitment from you. I really do. I don't get involved in wannabes or quitters or people who think that they know the industry better than me.
It's really embarrassing for one of the judges to come in and ask us if we're really committed to the competition.
Are you all taking it seriously?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, sure.
Honestly?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Billy?
I'm taking it really seriously.
Sheridan? I know I was a bit hard on you, but...
I'm glad you were, though.
As a model, you cannot get around it. Size is crucial.
I needed you to be hard on me.
You've got to do that.
And I realised, just like walking on that treadmill, how much I want.
Walking? You've got to go all out because you've wasted a lot of time.
I think they're spot on with me needing to lose weight. I don't need to lose that much, and I'm going to do it in a healthy way.
One more thing, and a very important thing. Half page. Inside the model's lair, and it really pisses me off. One more thing, and a very important thing.
He had a newspaper in his hand, which he was kind of beating on his hand, which didn't look too good to me.
Half page inside the model's lair. I was expecting a great article on you guys. I get an article on what a pigsty this place is. That just really upset me. And it really pisses me off. The fact that we lost an opportunity for the industry to see how great you guys were. Instead, they're showing a picture of what a pigsty this place is.
Can we just say, like...
Okay, let's have a look around.
No, right now,
let's have a look around.
We just ate.
All right, look, doesn't matter to me. Let's have a look around. Let's have a look at the kitchen. Has anyone swept here? Billy, right now, I want you to listen, and I don't want to hear any excuses, all right?
Sure.
After a week of this, you end up with cockroaches everywhere.
The next thing I knew, to my surprise, Varden had appointed one person to be the house leader.
Sarah, I'm going to pick you because I think you've got the maturity and the sophistication to be able to do it.
You didn't even glance up at me, you know, when you said the word maturity, and I like to think I've got a little bit. Sarah's seen as that mature one, but Martin doesn't see every side of Sarah. We do.
I think everybody was sort of taken aback, and I'm really happy because I have to admit I do clean up after myself.
Each week I want a new house leader. It's a big part of this job, guys.
He believes for a young person, she's quite mature. But he hasn't lived with her yet.
Sarah, let's have a chat about what this is going to involve.
She will love the role. She does think that she's the most mature person in the house.
I feel really, like, right in my space to do it now. Like, before, to tell people what to do, it felt really, like, I felt held back. But now that I'm told to do it, that's a good thing.
You right, Isaac? You going to start cleaning, mate?
The main offender is always a good mate of mine, Luke.
Luke?
That's the first time I've seen you.
This is usually the cleanest room of the house.
Whose room is this?
This is mine, Chanel and Connie's.
I think Tom's pretty disgusting too.
Tom? Showed him for the eviction process. Oh, stuff's
looks like out. A bomb's here.
Yeah. We'll show them how clean we are.
Beds, mate, every day.
People out there that think that the boys are the messy ones.
No, it's
you're
not
wrong.
Just the boys.
This is your charter, all right? This gives you the authority to make sure everyone keeps this house clean.
Okay.
Use it. Use the authority.
I will use it wisely.
arrived at the photo shoot this morning and we were on top of a 5-level car park. It looked really scary.
Hey guys.
Hello.
So this week has been about speed and motion. Yesterday at the AFL training session, you learnt the importance of being able to move your body in different ways. Today's photo shoot is all about capturing the moment. You'll need to keep control of your body and particularly your facial expressions in every single frame. So this is your photographer, Simon Upton. Hey, Simon.
Hi, Jen.
He's photographed the most famous people around the world, like Cindy Crawford, Fergie, and Naomi Watts. So you're in good hands. Listen to his direction.
So, guys, basically today we've got this trampoline set up. What it's going to entail you guys doing is being able to jump in the air and try to really have a controlled body position. You know, we really need you to concentrate and focus on being in the air and showing off the clothes as best as you can.
I think this is definitely going to reflect better for the boys, this shoot.
It's easier for the guys because they can just keep jumping. They're quite fit, whereas the girls, we might find it a bit hard. We might get exhausted easier. But I feel like we can do more poses than the boys can.
I think the boys are a bit ahead of the girls at the moment. I think we've got them.
Come on up, Shanina.
All right, let's go. What we'll do is you just bounce and bounce and bounce. Yeah, that was good, but I need it 3 feet higher. Change it up, mix it up. Take your legs out wider.
The one area where I could be a little bit critical of Shanina's effort today was she was very controlled of her facial expressions and she didn't quite have the leg strength, I think, to get as high as we would have liked.
I've been in the bottom three for weeks now and my photo shoots haven't been too good, so I really need to nail this photo shoot to really stay in the game.
Yeah, that's it. You look great. Really relaxed, mate, that's great. All right, let's try something different now. Let's get a big laugh. Go. Yeah, great. I love that. Excellent, buddy. Well done.
I have a picture. If he can get his catwalk, he can come in the top three.
Well, you know, I think he's got, mate, you know, he's got a great look.
Good, bro, really good.
You know, I think it's going to be so competitive. You really want to nail this photo shoot, at least do well enough to not have to rely on your catwalk.
Try and stay in the centre. Relax your mouth a little.
I'll be interested to see how the girls go. It is very hard work. It's way harder than I thought it would be.
Reese did a fantastic job. He basically did everything that I told him to do and a little bit more.
It was good. It was really hard work, though. It's really hard. The hardest thing you don't realise, but just jumping up and down for 20 minutes in the sun.
Oh, I'm worried. I'm scared of heights, especially on a 5-storey house.
But you're looking where he tells you to look. You don't really look off the building. But if you looked off the building and you're in there, you'd go, ooh.
Don't tell anyone I'm shooting myself. I don't want anyone to know.
And point your time.
Basically, with Courtney, we were really, like, you know, pushing her towards the end.
Kick the cameraman. Try and reach the cameraman. Point that toe and get it out there.
Control your face.
I felt that she didn't really give it everything she had.
You can push it harder, hun. You're hardly puffing.
Sheridan, give us a real scream.
Yeah, like,
I still can't hear you.
Bigger.
What's that? Bigger. That's like worse than my baby. Come on, louder, shout.
I really thought she would have excelled. And, you know, I didn't see any of that come through today.
Good.
Sarah just seemed a little bit cautious, a bit apprehensive about it. Her motivation levels, she's a bit, you know, half-hearted about it.
Your facial expression then? You sort of were in pain. Change something, do something different.
If I had to rate Sarah out of 10, I'd probably give her a 5 out of 10 for that performance.
Now just a little bit more front on and just drop one leg down and bring one leg back.
It's looking like it's a bit too much like a circus, what guys do at the gym and stuff.
I hate bagging people, but he's not a model. Simple as that.
Billy, stop. Just stop. The winner of Make Me a Supermodel will receive a contract with Chadwick Modelling Agency, international representation with New York Model Management, a spread in Australia's number one fashion magazine, Marie Claire, and the chance to become the world's next supermodel.
Billy, stop. Just stop. For 1 second, stop, because I think you're too far removed from the centre of where you need to be. It's still a fashion shot.
I think it was sort of all a little bit too much like he was hanging out at a gymnasium with his mates, like being a bit of a goof.
Right now, I've got, like, the worst feeling in my stomach. This is the most scared I've been in the competition.
I hope I don't throw this up on the trampoline.
Luke? Want you to meet Simon Upton?
Nice to meet you.
He heard that Reese and Isaac have done well.
They're my trio. We're the trio in the house, so we'll let the boys
down. Well, there you
go. Can't let the boys down.
They've set the mark.
They have. They've done really well, those guys. The pressure was put on him earlier on in the day by hearing that his two good mates had done so well. So he came out, and I think he might have been a little bit nervous about that. No, we don't want star jumps. Okay, they're for the circus. You're going too high. I feel Luke is really thinking about himself. He still seems a little raw to me. Woo! He doesn't really quite understand maybe what a good pose is.
Isaac sounds like he's had a really good photo shoot. He's really lifted up his game and he's a real threat, so it's game on indeed.
I was thinking that I could spin while I'm
here. Mate, try it. It's great. Good. I like it. Be aware of your face, though. Tom definitely had initiative today. He came out here. He seemed really determined. Good. I like it. Try it again. Go that again. That sort of stuff's good. You know why I like that? Because no one's done that today.
And I really don't know how I'm going to go.
You're not scared of heights, really, are you?
Yeah. My only fear is dancing and heights.
Dancing and heights. All right, let's go. You've got to have confidence. There's no reason why you can't go any higher. Everyone thinks it's easy, but, you know, there's many an instance where you'll get called into a shoot like the one we're doing today where it's not going to be easy and it might not be something that you're comfortable with. You're looking a little bit timid. Relax your face.
You've got an advantage because you're so limber. You do yoga, so just do lots of shape. That was one of the hardest photo shoots I've ever done. I think that all in all, there will be like maybe 5 or 10 good frames in there, but I shot maybe 40 frames, so there should have been 35.
You'll be right.
I don't know if I'm being too hard on myself, I don't know.
You're not being too hard on yourself. You feel like you haven't done as well as you thought you were going to, but you said that from the start you were scared of heights. I think you'll be fine.
I just hope Sarah it'd be too good to lose her and Lucas in one fall.
Hi, model.
This morning we arrived and Colleen, our walking trainer, was here and she had 10 powerful treadmills behind her.
Up until now you've pretty much been walking at one constant speed. So the thing you guys need to know is that most designers do require a certain pace and variety in their catwalk.
So looking at the treadmills, I think we're all a bit scared and wondering why we're wearing heels and why there were treadmills in the same room.
So today's training session is about learning how to vary your speed on the runway. How do you feel?
Good.
Yeah?
Practice.
Good girl. Keep those arms moving, girls, just for balance with those heels on, yeah? Boys, I have to say, I think you're actually maintaining focus. You girls really need to stay on eye line now, and let's see who's got it, the guys or the girls.
I do want it quite bad this week. I mean, I feel my photo shoot went quite well. If I have a good catwalk, then maybe I'll make it into the top three. I'm hoping so.
How are you going, Sarah? What's going on?
It was difficult for me because my shoes, they weren't fitting properly, so I developed some really nasty blisters.
Unfortunately, that's just that's one of the things you have to put up with as a model, to have sore feet, because you'll always be in high heels and you're always going to be walking a lot.
It seems to be a recurring thing with her pulling out of challenges. I think she's just got maybe a low pain threshold or something, but she needs to push through it a bit more, I think.
I just don't want my feet to be, like, damaged in catwalk. Mine are sore, but, you know, I kept going. So it's been a couple of days since Martin's last visit, so come and have a look at the house now. So here's the lounge room and the dining room, which is Reese and Sheridan's job to maintain, and they've done a really good job with that. Lovely and clean, something new, something nice.
I think, you know, Miss Maturity Sarah, as she's kind of been labelled, it probably was suited to the role for her staff. I wouldn't have minded having it myself.
This is Shanina and Courtney's job, and as you can see, it's cleaner than ever.
If we don't make our bed, Sarah reports us to Martin as being lazy.
Now, the new rule is, every morning Luke and Tom go around, and if there's any piece of clothing left on the floor, it goes in the pool.
Yes! Yes!
It's like a lot of Reese's stuff. This morning, about 4 of Reese's shirts were in the swimming pool. So it's serious.
I didn't warn you guys.
Good the pool, man.
Done deal.
It was either Luke or Tom that came up with that rule about throwing clothes in the pool. Yeah, trust them to find that rule.
Today's catwalk day. This week all the boys had a great advantage over the girls, I think. I think this week you'll be seeing more boys in top three.
Isaac's a big chance of top three this week. What a transformation that would be. Just a Cinderella story. Wake up, Cinderella.
Hey, guys. This week has been about harnessing speed and understanding the movements of your body. At the photo shoot, you needed to make shapes to bring the clothes to life. Today, on the runway, you will need to change the speed at which you walk. So, let me introduce you to the turntable. Hey, guys.
Hi, Jen.
So, let me introduce you to the turntable. Your challenge today is to strike a pose while standing and spinning on this turntable. It looks easy, but it's not.
You've done that.
Yes.
You guys will be wearing mod-inspired clothes. To nail this catwalk, you're going to need a touch of arrogance and a lot of confidence whilst doing your poses.
Remember, this is your last chance to impress us. At the end of today's catwalk, 3 of you will be put up for the vote. Good luck. Let's get you styled.
So on catwalk days during styling, we're weighed to see if we've lost weight or gained weight.
57.2.
You can't walk out there looking like a blimp, and at the same time you can't walk out there looking like Skeletor, so you know, you've got to find that happy medium once again.
77.8. 70.3.
Yay. I've just been weighed and I've lost 1 kilo this week. I'm a big girl, like I'm not fat. I've got big bones, I've got wide shoulders. I've been dreading this day just because last week I was in the bottom three, and I really hope that I get out there and that they know that I've lost weight and they can see that I've been working really hard. As I was stepping up onto the revolver, I was thinking, do not look down because you lose focus.
As I was approaching the turntable, I was a bit scared. You just worry that you're just going to stuff it up. What was going through my mind was, I have to impress. Just go out there, be strong, let the face do all the work.
I think my catwalk was pretty good. However, you can easily lose your focus. Strong and confident, and then I just instantly just thought I had to dump it.
As the weeks go by, you guys are getting better and the competition is getting harder. It's not enough just to complete an assignment, you actually have to stand out from the pack. One small mistake will put you in the bottom three and you'll have to face the public vote, so keep that in mind. And in saying that, we will ask you a few questions. Courtney.
Jen.
So bouncing on a trampoline in the sunshine seems like an easy shoot, an easy day, but it's harder than it looks, right?
Yes.
How did you enjoy
it? Yes, it is. When I saw the photo in my portfolio, I thought, oh, no, it's not as good as I thought it would be, so I was a little bit disappointed.
Well, I don't think you really got the shot, to be honest.
No, I don't think I got the shot either.
You've got no neck at all, your head's right down.
No, I agree.
I don't think you got the shot. So, Sarah, on the photo shoot, do you think you focus too much on your face rather than your body?
I'm happy with the shot with how my body looks, but no, you're right. Definitely was thinking about it too much.
Well, the feedback from the photographer was your face and your body weren't married together, and it was quite disjointed. It is something that you're going to have to really focus on.
Yeah, I'd agree.
Sheridan.
Hi, Jackie.
When you were on the trampoline, I asked you to shout.
Yeah.
Sheridan, give us a real scream.
I felt like my facial expression sort of wouldn't have done me any good in the photo, because when I did scream, I sort of, like, my mouth would have been open.
Well, there was a reason for it.
Yeah.
There was no expression happening, and you didn't trust us to get from you what we were trying to do. You didn't go for it. You didn't take direction.
Mm. I gave it one shot and I thought, well, I don't think that's working. But
these are little tricks of the trade. That's where experience comes through. And that's why you guys are getting the benefit of this sort of experience. Someone like Jackie who gives you those little technique hints, grab them with both hands.
Mm-hmm.
Why are you upset now, Sarah? Why are you upset now, Sarah?
Because I go to a photo shoot and I just don't even know the basics. Every week I'm coming back and not having a great photo
That's
shoot.
Because you haven't asked the questions.
Mm.
From now on, going forward, questions.
And I just don't feel at the moment that I know enough about even being a model to become a supermodel. And that's what worries me.
That's exactly what we're here for. This is Make Me a Supermodel.
Personally, I just want to see that spark back. Have a bit of fun. Isaac, you seem totally relaxed and at ease at the photo shoot. Did you feel like that?
Yeah, I did. I felt pretty relaxed from the get-go.
And the feedback from the photographer, from Simon, he said you're a standout. You took direction really well.
Thank you.
You're one of the best.
He's a nice bloke, isn't he?
No. You guys are all clapping, but Isaac has gone from the bottom three to being
front
runner.
Yeah.
He's a competitor now.
It's funny though, he was everyone's little protege at the start. Everyone couldn't wait to give him their little tips and so forth, but I think the tips will kind of die off a little bit now.
Guys, it's not a joke. It's actually serious. You are in a competition. There are major prizes to be won. There's a whole modelling contract. You're standing here before us. Do you or do you not want to win Make Me a Supermodel? Hannah,
I'm one person that since Cassie's left, I've put the competition as my main focus.
Billy, are you the next supermodel?
I think I am.
Luke?
Yeah, I do believe I am.
Isaac, what do you have to say?
I want to win this thing.
Sheridan?
Yeah. If I didn't want it, I wouldn't be here right now.
Shanina?
I want to be the supermodel in the group.
Don't believe you.
Grace, how do you think you went at the photo shoot?
I think I did okay. I wasn't entirely happy.
I think you've got to watch about being too laid back.
Yeah.
I'd like to see a bit more spark in you now.
Mm-hmm.
But apart from all that, I loved your shot. I thought the shot was great. It looked like you were jumping out of the city.
Mm.
But I think you really do need to ramp up your intensity really now.
Righto.
Shanina, what's wrong? Take a breath. Come on.
It just hurts me.
What hurts you, darling?
A lot.
Pardon?
When I say, like, I really do want to be here. I know I come off soft, but I have no idea how much I want to be here. That's what.
So tell me, with the fire in your belly, that you want to be here.
I want to be here.
I can't hear you. You're shouting at me.
I want to be a supermodel.
I believe you. It's great to see that.
Thanks for that, guys. If you want to head backstage, we'll assess your work. We'll decide who's in the bottom three and who will face the public vote.
During the judges' questions, I had been feeling really ill.
I know, I'm just nervous, like throbbing headache, like right there. I'm right there for the past like 4 hours. It just made me feel like shit then. So I ran to the toilet.
You're gonna be alright?
Yeah, I have to be alright.
I
can't go up on stage.
Wasn't that emotional?
Yeah, I don't always like to see people crying, but if it means bringing out that emotion, you know.
Yeah, you can see that was a relief. Mm. So what about these shots? I know your favourites, Tom.
I loved the way he recovered on the runway when he lost his beads.
Yeah, it was very professional.
Very professional.
Yeah,
and on his photo shoot, he really did wow both Simon and myself because he came out, he'd thought about it, and he started doing different moves. And unlike Luke, unfortunately, we've got a good shot in the end, but it was Chinese torture to get there.
Really? Mm.
He just didn't know how to work the clothes.
Mm. He's just got such a great face, though.
He's got a great look. He looks like a model.
Billy, we're going to disagree on this, aren't we?
I love that. Shot is amazing.
No, he just didn't follow direction on that.
Billy do a T, though, isn't it?
Well, that's the problem with Billy.
Yeah, I know, but that still, I'd rather see something that we can pull back a bit rather than trying to get someone going.
Reese. Beautiful photograph.
That's a fantastic shot.
He looks like a model.
But I do think he's got to become more intense. That the laid-back thing, sometimes I do doubt whether he's really keen for this.
We know who our top three are and our bottom four, so let's get the models out.
I feel like I'm not getting that reprieve. Like, you know, first week I was in the bottom three. Second week, boosted up to the top three. Third week, bottom four. Fourth week, bottom four. Then I just went and got the questions and answers and it looks like I'm going to be bottom three again. Can't you see I'm trying so hard? And I feel like I do have what it takes. I just need, you know, I just need a break.
Models, as you know, during deliberation, Courtney has taken ill. She was supposed to be one of the seven that stood before us. Unfortunately, she was too sick to do so, but we must continue. We can now reveal to the rest of you that based on her photo shoot and catwalk performance tonight, Courtney has been selected to be in the bottom three. Sarah, I know it will be hard, but being house leader, I would like you to tell her.
Yeah, definitely, of course.
Reese, you did a great job at the photo shoot. We all felt that your shot was worthy of a fashion magazine editorial. You are safe. You may now leave the catwalk.
Sarah, in the photo shoot, your facial expressions didn't match your body poses. And on the runway, you're still too flat-footed. You're in the bottom four.
Tom, your moves were great on the photo shoot. You made the clothes look fantastic. And on the runway, the broken necklace, not a problem. You are this week's winner. Your reward is waiting for you off the runway. You are now safe to leave the catwalk. Well done.
Sheridan, your moves and poses on the photo shoot were very limited. The photographer struggled to get a good shot. You're in the bottom four.
Luke and Isaac, one of you has done extremely well this week. The other one has not.
Luke, you were very nervous at the photo shoot and you seemed more concerned with your mate's performances than your own. You are in the bottom four.
Isaac, you simply had a great photo shoot this week. You looked relaxed and you seemed to really enjoy yourself. And it was the same on the runway. You are safe, you can leave the catwalk. Well done. Three of you are standing before us. Two of you will be joining Courtney in the bottom three and will face the public vote. Sarah. You're up for the vote. Sheridan and Luke. One of you is safe this week, but the other will be up for the audience vote. Sheridan. You're up for the vote. That means, Luke, you are safe. You may leave the catwalk. Models, the decision is out of our hands now. It's up to Australia to decide who cannot be made into a supermodel. Good luck, stay strong. You may leave the catwalk. Coming up next week, sexual chemistry. Things get hot and heavy on and off the catwalk. And don't miss all the action on Off the Runway. That's Tuesday night at 10:30.
How do you feel, Lucas?
Is that light on my cheek, bro?
Lucas, how about you let us worry about the lighting?
You can see a whole lot more and watch the entire episode again for free at our website, yahoo7.com.au/TV.